Well, Barry Bonds will have a shot at history on the regular season's final day here at Pac Bell Park. It is also Fan Appreciation Day as the Giants square off against the Los Angeles Dodgers. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Glenn Kuiper, and welcome to the Diamond of California Giants pregame report. It is our final show of this 2003 season. Now, this is what is coming up on this afternoon show. We'll go inside the game and preview the Florida Marlins, who are the Giants' first-round opponent. Barry Bonds will have one more game this year to catch his godfather, Willie Mays. And our cover story today looks back at the second half of the season when the Giants got hot and took control of the division. Well, it will be the Barry Bonds watch today as he is just two home runs away from his godfather, Willie Mays, for third place on the all-time home run list. Bonds has played in two of the first three games of the series against the Dodgers, and he is in the lineup this afternoon playing left field and hitting cleanup. On Friday night here at Pac Bell, Bonds inched one home run closer to Mays' fifth inning. He deposits a deep shot into the seats in right field, number 658 in his career and number 45 on the year. Yesterday, Bonds played in game one of the doubleheader. First at bat, he was hit by a pitch. Second at bat, he was intentionally walked for the 61st time this year. His third at bat, he strikes out swinging on a high fastball. And his final at bat, left-hander Tom Martin gets Bonds swinging on a nasty breaking ball. So Bonds finishes the game 0-for-2. And Bonds has never faced the Dodgers' left-handed starter today. That is Wilson Alvarez. Now, as the Giants close out the regular season, the players and their fans will no doubt be thinking about Tuesday afternoon when the Giants open up the playoffs against the Florida Marlins. Here's a look at the pitching matchups for that series. Starting with Tuesday afternoon, game one, it'll be Josh Beckett and Jason Schmidt. Game two on Wednesday, Brad Penny and Sidney Ponzone. Game three on Friday in Florida, left-handers Mark Redmond and Kirk Reeder. And game four on Saturday, rookies Dontrell Willis and Jerome Williams. Let's not forget about the home field advantage in the National League. That has yet to be decided. But right now, the Atlanta Braves are leading the Philadelphia Phillies 5-2. That game is in the sixth inning. If the Braves win, they will have the best record in the National League, and they will have home field advantage throughout the playoffs. And if they lose and the Giants win, well, then the Giants will get home field advantage if they get to the second round. But right now, the Braves are winning 5-2 in the sixth inning, and we keep a close eye on that game throughout the show. Now let's take a look at our Diamond of California Giant on the diamond. It is Cy Young candidate Jason Schmidt. He finished the regular season 17-5 with an NL best 2.34 ERA. And Jason Schmidt, game one starter on Tuesday, is our Giant on the diamond. Up next on the show, we'll go inside the game when Duane Kuiper and Mike Krukow take a close-up look at the Florida Marlins, the Giants' first-round playoff opponent. We'll have that when we come back.
The Giants pregame is brought to you by Diamond of California. Try Diamond's full line of delicious nuts, including glazed nuts for snacking. Available in four irresistible flavors. Original, butter toffee, apple cinnamon, and pecan pie. And by Just for Men. More than a hair color, it's the Rejuvenator. Ends gray in 5 minutes. Looks natural.
1997 Division Series, Giants and Marlins at Candlestick Park. Devon White off of Wilson Alvarez. That was the crushing blow, a grand slam home run. The Marlins would win the game and sweep the three-game series, and of course they would go on to win the 1997 World Series. Welcome back to the Diamond of California Giants pregame report. After today's regular season final, the Giants will set their sights on those Florida Marlins. Be careful with the Marlins. They will finish this regular season with the third most wins in the National League. Now let's go inside the numbers and take a look at the season series between the Giants and the Marlins. Giants won five of the six games played, but all six games were decided by three runs or less. The Giants hit 35 points higher than Florida, but outscored them by just four runs, and the Giants pitching was very good against Florida, a 2.83 ERA. Now, Barry Bonds played in four of the six games played against Florida, going 3-for-10 with a home run and eight walks. Now to talk about those Florida Marlins some more, let's check in with our game announcers, Duane Kuiper and Mike Krukow. And guys, give the Marlins credit. They're doing what you're supposed to do. They're hot at the end of the year. They've won 20 out of their last 28 games heading into the postseason.
Well, you're right, Glenn. Plus, you know, under their new manager, you know, they've had a phenomenal record since Jeff Torborg was fired. So, I mean, I think the Giants know that the Marlins are going to give them all that they can handle. Plus, they've got one thing that a lot of teams don't have. They have speed.
They have lots of speed. They have it on the base paths, and they have it on the defensive side of the ball as well. And I think the big thing about this series, as every playoff series, is you have two teams that are very confident. And I think that if there's any edge, it's with the Giants for the simple reason that the Marlins are doing it for the first time. And when you do it for the first time, I think it's a huge disadvantage because you're overwhelmed in a lot of different areas away from the field. How to handle tickets, how to handle relatives, how to get them accommodated. These are all distractions. Distractions the Giants team is not going to have. So I think if there's any edge at all, I think it's the fact the Giants, for the most part, have been here before, and they know how to handle the adrenaline, and they do know how to handle all the outside distractions.
And guys, the only guy in the Giants lineup who really has not been to the playoffs is Jose Cruz Jr. I know Sidney Ponzon has never been there. Jerome Williams hasn't been there, but you're right, Giants with much more experience. If you're a Giants player who's been through what happened last year, the playoffs, do you say anything to Jose Cruz Jr. or Sidney Ponzon, or you just kind of let them learn as the playoffs get started?
Well, I don't think you need to say anything to them. I mean, you might pat them on the back and say, hey, enjoy this, have some fun, but don't change what you've done throughout the course of the regular season. I mean, they know what's at stake. And trust me, they're going to take this all in, and they're going to enjoy every minute of it.
Well, I think the theme for this playoff series is that treat every game like it's ninth innings. And you have to feel that sense of urgency going into a playoff game as a player. There's no sneaking up into a flow, into a rhythm. You've got to be ready from that first inning on, because that first inning may determine the outcome of that ball game. And I think that's one thing as a player who's never been through it before has to pick up on from the experienced players, that you have to be ready to go.
All right, good advice. Thanks a lot, guys. Duane and Mike will be coming up in just a little bit. So slowing down the speedy Marlins may be the key to the series for the San Francisco Giants. And the guy who makes the Marlins go big time is leadoff man Juan Pierre. He is the guy the Giants got to stop. His first year as a Florida Marlin has been a great one. Pierre has 203 hits. That is the third highest total in the National League this year. He also has 7 triples. And he also leads the entire major leagues in stolen bases with 64. He has become one of the most disruptive offensive players in the National League. And don't forget about the other speedster at the top of the Florida Marlins lineup, Luis Castillo. He's got a .314 batting average with 187 hits. Castillo and Juan Pierre, keep them off the bases. You got a real good chance to beat the Florida Marlins. Now, as we go to break, let's check out our Just for Men hair color rejuvenating play. Let's go back to May 13th, maybe the strangest play of the year. Nafy Perez would sneak home on an infield fly rule pop-up that was not caught by the Montreal Expos. It is one of our favorite plays of the year. Get in there, Nafy. Just sneak in there. There you go, and you're safe. That is our Just for Men hair color rejuvenating play. Just for Men, it is more than a hair color. It is the Rejuvenator. Champion sounds nice. The Giants are not resting on their laurels. This season, there are some new faces mixed in with the old. A new veteran manager. A Cy Young contender. A new closer. And a player for the ages. The win was wire to wire, but the job is not finished. It has only begun. Jim Brouwer doing good by the fans as we get set for the season finale here at Pac Bell Park. It is the Giants and the Dodgers. Welcome back, everybody. Barry Bonds is certainly the centerpiece of this Giants team, but you don't win the division by 14 and a half games without having real good players on your roster. Now, all year long, the Giants have had contributions from all 25 guys, sometimes even rookies who have come up in the middle of the year. And all that has led to a terrific season, and there's been a few surprises along the way as well. How about Marquise Grissom? He wanted a chance to play every day. Dodgers said no. Giants said yes, and he has played in 149 games, 300 hitter, 20 home runs. The Giants say thank you to the Dodgers for letting them have Marquise Grissom. Jerome Williams, just 22 years old. He arrived early in the year. What an addition. 7-5, a 3.30 ERA, and he is a member of the Giants playoff rotation. How about Andrés Galarraga? How much has he meant to this team both on and off the field? The big cat with a .301 average, 12 home runs, 42 RBIs. Last night he showed a little speed. He has played in 110 games, for the Giants. The leader of the pitching staff, and no question, big right-hander Jason Schmidt. He has reached his full potential this year, and now he is a Cy Young candidate, league best 2.34 ERA. He'll take the mound in game one on Tuesday. Shortstop Rich Aurelia, eighth year as a San Francisco Giant, 277, 58 RBIs, great postseason last year. And Aurelia, he's going to hit right in front of Barry Bonds in that postseason. Speaking of Bonds, best player in the game on a division-winning team, nobody impacts the game the way Bonds does. Something is wrong if he does not win the NL MVP award again this year. So let's not forget, the Giants, yes, they have the best player in baseball, but they also have 24 other very good players. That is the reason why the Giants have won the division, and that is the reason why the Giants, once again this year, are a very, very good team. Stick around when the Diamond of California Giants pregame report continues from Pac Bell. The CEO of Diamond Nuts, Michael Mendez, will join us. We'll talk about that, and we'll have more from Pac Bell Park as we get set for the Giants and the Dodgers.
Pregame has been brought to you by Diamond of California. Try Diamond's full line of delicious nuts, including glazed nuts for snacking. Available in four irresistible flavors: original, butter toffee, apple cinnamon, and pecan pie.
Well, the sun has just come out, and it is a beautiful day at the ballpark as we continue with the Diamond of California Giants pregame report before the Giants and the Dodgers. Welcome back, everybody. On Friday night, we looked back at the first half of this 2003 season for the Giants, but it was the second half where the Giants really took control in the National League West. Our cover story looks back at the second half dominance of the Giants this year.
Since the opening of Pac Bell Park, few teams have enjoyed a home field advantage like the Giants. In first place by 5 games over Arizona, the Giants began the second half of the season with an 11-game homestand and an opportunity to put some pressure on their closest rivals. Up first were the Colorado Rockies. After a 4-game sweep, into town came the Diamondbacks, now trailing by 7 games. A sweep by either team, and it is a whole new ball game. Game 1, Yorvit Torrealba drives in 3 runs, and Tim Worrell slams the door. The Giants win it 3-1. Game 2, a struggling Damian Moss outduels Curt Schilling, as the Giants prevail 3-1. Game 3, Bonds' 2-run blast leads the rout, 7-1 the final. Game 4 was a tight battle. With the score tied in the ninth, Bonds stole the show with his arm.
On the ground towards the hole, here comes Bonds. He gets to it. Here's his throw. It's on line. They got him!
And before everyone had caught their breath, Barry stepped to the plate.
Swing and a drive! Left center field! This one is over!
The Giants finished the homestand 10-1. And their lead over Arizona had grown to 11 games in the NL West. The Giants continued to roll along, but in mid-August, on an Eastern trip in which, for the most part, Bonds was away to be with his ailing father, the team went winless and saw their lead shrink to 8.5 games, with a homestand looming against 2 tough opponents, the Braves and the Marlins. What we witnessed over those next 3 days was that these Giants are a team of heart and metal. As August turned to September, the Giants took their 11.5 game lead to Arizona, where the Diamondbacks needed a sweep or else all was lost. They won the first game, but over the final 3, the Giants put the division away.
August 30th, Bonds homers off Randy Johnson. The Giants win 2-1. August 31st, Schmidt and Worrell shut down the D-backs. Giants win 3-1. September 1st, behind Sidney Ponson's pitching and Bonds' clutch hitting, the Giants win 2-0. 25 games remain, but it was time to look forward to October. The culmination of a season's hard work happened on September 17th as the Giants completed their wire-to-wire West Division championship. A great accomplishment, but with last season's ending, you know their work had just begun.
Well, the Giants are 42-24 in the second half. That is the best second half record in the National League. Well, that is going to do it for our final edition of the Diamond of California Giants pregame report. A special thanks to Diamond of California, our title sponsor. Also, a special thanks to Sean Madison from Fox Sports Net for all his hard work on the show. For Bip Roberts, I'm Glenn Kuiper. Thanks for joining us. Coming up, it's the Giants and the Dodgers.
What a year for the Giants. A wire-to-wire finish. The best home record in the National League. And with a victory today, the Giants will reach the 100-win mark. It's been a season to remember, but now it's time for the playoffs. Today, the Giants wave goodbye to the regular season. Giants, Dodgers, coming up next.
Mark. Beautiful day here at Pacvel Park, final game of this four-game series. Lots of sunshine, and it's between the Dodgers and the Giants. Hi again, everybody. I'm Duane Kuiper. Alongside me is Mike Krukow. Well, thanks for joining us all year here on Fox Sports Net. And, Mike, you know, still some things at stake. Hey, the Giants, if anything, can win 100 games with a win today.
Well, they want to win 100, but more importantly, they want to win. They want that feeling of a win going into the playoffs on Tuesday. So it's more than just a maintenance game. Guys will be going to try and emulate the same type of intensity that they'll be taking in the game on Tuesday. Have good quality at bats. Go out and get your innings in. Don't get hurt. And, hey, mix in a win.
That's right. And I guess the bottom line to this is it still is the Giants against the Dodgers. All right. Baseball's coming up. We'll have the lineups in the first pitch right after this. Waiting for the Giants to come out. It's the Giants and Dodgers. Rob Nen took the lineup card out today. How about that? So the Giants coming out of their dugout. And let's take a look at the Dodgers lineup. Cesar Asturias will lead it off, followed by Obert Cabrera. Then it's Sean Green. 19 home runs this season. That's his lowest total with the Dodgers. Ventura, the cleanup hitter. Then it's Beltre, Bernitz, Ross, Cora, and Wilson Alvarez, the former Giant.
All right, let's take a look at the scout report brought to you by your Northern California Toyota dealers. On Kevin Correa, he's got a fastball, real good sink, very effective down around the knees. I think slider is his best pitch to strike out. He will throw a changeup, which is also a good pitch. And when you mix the three together, he can be very dominant. It all depends on his command of the strike zone. And I think for him, like every pitcher who goes out there, especially young pitchers, be aggressive early in the count. That sets it up. The McDonald's defense playing behind Kevin Correa looks like this. Across the outfield, it'll be Bonds, Hammonds, and Cruz, who has 18 outfield assists. That's a record in the San Francisco era of the Giants. Across the infield, it'll be Alfonso, Aurelia, Durham, and Snow. And Yorvi Torreal gets the assignment to put the signs down and do the catching. The numbers on Correa. He's in his 10th game, his 7th start. He's 2-1. His ERA 3.48. Outstanding numbers. 24 strikeouts in 33 and two-thirds innings. Also good. He's got good stuff. Let's take a look at our Mercedes-Benz keys of the game. And the first thing, Correa's command. His last couple starts, it has not been good. He has lost a lot of pitches up in the strike zone. He has to be down to be effective. And don't try and pull Wilson Alvarez. Right-handed hitters, he's going to work that outside part of the plate with a fastball that runs away from you, a little backdoor breaking ball, and a changeup. You have to try and go the opposite way with him. And why not win 100 games? Sounds better.
It does.
I asked Jose Cruz the other day, what are your goals? And he was sitting on 19 home runs and said, I want to hit 20 because it looks better. Well, 100 looks better than 99.
So here's Cesar Asturias, and we're about ready for the first pitch of this game, and it is high and away. 107 first pitch. And it's 68 degrees here in San Francisco. Asturias hitting 248, a home run, 39 RBIs, and he bunts it foul. Ricardo Alfonso was playing in and still will be. One ball and one strike to Asturias. Giants and Dodgers split a doubleheader yesterday. And the Giants won on Friday night, 10-1. Here's the 1-1 pitch and another bunt. And it's going to be Carreras. No, not in time. And that'll be a bunt single.
A pretty nice try from Correa to even make the play close. This is a perfect bunt pushed down by Asturias. And when you have speed to go with it, that's a rough combination. And the Dodgers had their little leadoff hitter on. Asturias can really take a page out of Dave Roberts' book. Dave Roberts has become an outstanding bunter. But Asturias 3-6, it took him to get out of the box and get to first base. That's pressure on defense.
Here's Cabrera, runner goes, pitches inside, to throw down to second is high. And Asturias has his 10th steal of the year.
I mean, how disruptive is that? I mean, a guy hits the ball about 20 feet from home plate and within a pitch, he's standing on second base. And that's what speed can do to you.
Yep.
Kevin Correa concentrating more to the strike zone than he was to the runner at first base. And Torre Alba not giving much of a chance. Boy, he had a huge jump.
Well, they're going to have to keep an eye on his tourists again. Aurelia is trying to hold them close. And there's the pitch up and in. Two balls in, no strikes.
And this changes the whole at bat for Cabrera as you saw him squirt a bunt. Cabrera's a pretty good bat handler. He could put a ball on the right side of the infield, which should be his, the very least he accomplishes in this at bat if Tracy takes the bunt off.
And a strike. Two balls and one strike. Green on deck. Atlanta beating Philadelphia. That's in the ninth. It's 5-2. Two balls and a strike. And it's low. Doing the umpiring is Jerry Meals. He's calling balls and strikes. Puccioni at first, Ripley at second, and Vanover is umpiring at third. Just underway here at Pac Bell Park. Correa needs to throw a strike, and Cabrera lifts one to left. Bonds moving back. Now Bonds moving over. Tagging is Asturias. Here's the throw, and it is over. Thrown a bit by Bonds, and Asturias gets into third.
So Cabrera finds a way to get the man over third base with a productive out. Nice job there from Bonds. He knew that Asturias was going to try and tag. Watch him get some momentum into the play so he can get something behind the throw. No use hitting your cutoff man there. Don't need to. That play is only going to third. No back runner. And it's backed up by the pitcher. Got nothing to lose.
On the ground to Snow, coming in to score is Asturias, and Green is retired. He does get the RBI, two outs. It's RBI number 85 for Sean Green. So a little ball comes into play here in the first inning. And Robin Ventura is going to hit. And a first pitch strike. Ventura started out with the Yankees. Five home runs, 13 RBIs, hitting 226. The ball sailed inside. One ball and one strike. Adrian Beltre is on deck. 1-1 to Ventura.
and a strike. One and two. Dodgers with a record of 85-76. And that pitch is high, 2-2. They have lost three of their last four. And they are 6-12 against the Giants this year. 2-2 pitch. Ventura out on strikes on the high fastball. One run on one hit, none left. After one half inning, it's the Dodgers one. And Durham, Snow, and Aurelia coming up. Here's with a 1-0 lead. Giants are coming up. Here's their lineup. Ray Durham will lead it off. He'll be followed by J.T. Snow. Rich Aurelia hitting third. Then it's Barry Bonds. Bonds, 45 this year, 658 in his career. Alfonso, Hammonds, Cruz, Toyaba, and Correa to follow. And here's Wilson Alvarez throwing to Ray Durham, and a drive into the gap. And this is right smack dab in the gap. And Durham has got a double.
Right out of bed, first pitch fastball, put yourself in scoring position, pow! Let's take a look at our scout report brought to you by your Northern California Toyota dealer on Wilson Alvarez. His fastball will tail away from righties. He will challenge early with that fastball. He's got a big curveball and an outstanding changeup that he will throw at any time. 33-year-old lefty making his 21st appearance and 12th start of the season for the Dodgers. 5-0 with a 1.06 ERA. In his last nine starts, I mean, he has just been a great surprise for the Dodgers and a go-to guy his last couple weeks of the season.
Here's Snow. Inside to J.T. Snow. Rich Aurelia to follow.
It was great. The stadium radar gun had the first fastball to Ray Durham at 100 miles an hour. But that was the reading of the ball going out to left field.
Here's the 1-0. 2-0 to Snow.
Wilson Alvarez fastball is going to be between 84 and 88 miles per hour.
Snow lifts one to center field. Cabrera will catch. Will Durham tag? And Durham will tag. And here's the throw. And Durham makes it.
Nice job by J.T. Snow. A good at bat to get him over. Let's take a look at the McDonald's defense behind Alvarez today. Jim Tracy, the skipper for the Dodgers, has penciled in Burnett, Cabrera, and Green to patrol the outfield. Beltre, Easturas, Cora, and Ventura will play the infield. David Ross will do the catching. David Ross, we've been very impressed with in his ability to block balls.
Here's Rich Aurelia. Infield will play back. And Aurelia fouls it back.
Ooh, right on. You know, I think there should be a stat that rewards a guy like J.T. Snow for getting the ball deep enough in the outfield so a guy can move up 90 feet. Same thing for Gilbert Cabrera. Fly ball that allowed this tourist to go to third. I mean, that's a good at bat. It's a productive out. It should be a productive out category.
No balls and one strike. Swing and a pop up. This is not going to do it. Ross makes the catch. So a ground ball would have given the Giants a run, and now Barry Bonds is coming up.
Take a look at the Chevy home run tracker. Barry Bonds sitting on 658 career home runs for the year, 45.
That's brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. Shift is on for Bonds. With Durham at third, two outs. Swinging a drive into the alley. Cabrera coming over. He's not going to get it. comes in to score. Bonds with a single, and this game is tied.
RBI number 90 on the year for Barry Bonds, not wasting around. They know Wilson Alvarez. They play with him. They know he likes to get in that strike zone early. And they're sitting right there waiting for it. Just a high fastball right at the belt. And Bonds saying, oh, that looks pretty good from here. I'll take that. Thank you very much. RBI number 90.
And here's Alfonso. Alfonso takes a bit inside. One ball and no strike. Alfonso, 258, 12 home runs, 79 RBIs. And a strike. One ball and one strike.
Alfonso has hit him well, 3-for-7 lifetime.
Swing and a miss. 1-2. There it is. Triples Alley, Death Valley. That is a long way. Ball Downey in center field.
Down the line. Struck well. If it's fair, it's gone. Out of here.
That was too easy. That's about as relaxed a swing as you could put on a ball and have it leave the yard.
Edgardo Alfonso, home run number 13.
RBI's number 80 and 81. Just relaxed fastball, just jump all over it. The happy zone, middle in. Stay inside, see ya.
And stay hot.
And stay hot, you bet. That's the type of at bat you want to have going into a playoff series right there.
Here's Hammonds. Hammonds pops it up. Ross never saw it, but it's not going to matter. It's out of play.
It had the sound. It was just a matter of whether or not it would stay fair by a bunch. That's a deep one there.
Over the mound, and it trickles into center field. No one plays in the hole quite as much as Cesar Asturias does. And because of that, you'll see a lot of bouncing balls up the middle. There's the home run. Boy, he had a nice easy swing.
He really did, man. That was just about as fluid as you could put on a ball. That's the type of rhythm you really search for. And when you have it, hitting seems easy.
Cruz, a big home run last night to give him 20. And he watches a breaking ball go by, and it's a call strike. So after Relia had popped out, Bond singles and Alfonso homers. In the dirt, one ball and one strike. No one enjoyed Big Cat's stolen base last night more than Edgardo Alfonso, his fellow countryman. He had a blast with it.
That's the most animated we've seen Alfonso all year long. He couldn't hold it.
There's a strike, 1-2. So Hammonds at first. Giants with four hits here in the first inning. Off the end of the bat, foul.
So that score, the Braves leading the Phillies 5-2 that game in the bottom of the ninth inning. The last three outs ever at Veterans Stadium.
Now I saw yesterday they brought back their all-time team. There's a base hit to left. Alvarez not fooling anybody right now. Well, Mike said it earlier. This guy has been really sensational and a good story for the Dodgers. It's a rough first inning here at Pac Bell Park today.
Rob Ventura sent out by the Dodgers dugout. Got to slow things down a little bit for Alvarez.
We've seen it from time to time that some guys will have trouble in that first inning. Right. Jim Lynch and Chuck telling us that Alvarez has seen too many orange people.
I agree with you. That t-shirt's hysterical.
Torrealba hitting 264. How about that? That'll add to the rivalry. Fellow countryman, your Torrealba.
I mean, he just gets plunked. There's no doubt in anybody in that Giants dugout. No doubt in their minds that that was intentional.
Well, the thing that you have to be careful of if you're the Giants, you can't get involved in one of these, not with the first round of the playoffs starting on Tuesday. You can't do it.
Tell them.
Well, that's my point. I mean,
that would hurt.
You just don't want anybody to get flunked at this point.
Listen to this. I mean, this is flush. That's good wood on his elbow. That's still barking. He wants to rub that so bad. He will not give Alvarez the satisfaction. But it's killing him. And suddenly all the smiles that were in the Giants dugout are gone.
Correa, 1-3-11. That's a base hit. Hammond scores. Correa knocks in a run. And it's 4-1.
And that's a real big league hit. His first one was kind of a dead bird, little floater out the short outfield. This one, that's a big league knock and an RBI. Second of the year.
That's a great act.
Yep. Torrealba thinks so. That'll make that sting in that elbow feel a little better.
Durham gets to hit again. Outside, since Aurelia popped out, the Giants have had six straight base runners. And oh, and nobody up in the bullpen.
There's orange people everywhere.
Three and oh.
Hey, what they do if the umpire crew senses that as a pitcher, you're hitting somebody on purpose, that strike zone can get real small.
Yeah, that last pitch got pitching coach Jim Colburn right to the edge of the railing. 3-0 to Durham. And a strike, 3-1.
This is best velocity fastball yet, 88 miles per hour.
Durham pops it out of play. It's 3-2.
3-2. The runners will be on the move. Here it comes to Durham. Durham takes high. He walked him. A run comes in. And here's J.T. Snow. Giants have now scored 5 runs. Up high to Snow.
Let's take a look at the professional grade brought to you by GMC Trucks. Giants 43-12 in the last 55 games, and they've scored 4 more runs. And that would include today. They have scored more than 4 runs.
No, it's a pop-up down the third baseline. Beltre moving over in foul territory, and he dropped it. Orange people.
He's got plenty of room. He's got plenty of time. And the normal sure-handed Adrian Beltre dropping one. And reluctantly, Rodney Meyer starts to get loose for the Dodgers in their bullpen.
One ball and one strike. Two and one. Six hits in the inning, a walk, and Torrealba was hit by a pitch. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2. Snow kind of pulled out on that swing. Edgardo Alfonso, a home run this inning. Two and two. Snow hits one high into left center field in the park. Cabrera moving over, now drifting back, and that ends the inning. Giants score 5 times. We've played 1 inning. Edgardo Alfonso, bye bye baby. 5-1 Giants.
Ballpark 5-1 Giants as we go to the second inning. Now today in Philadelphia, the Atlanta Braves won their 101st game of the year, and that gives them the best record in the National League here in 2003. The final out in that game, Chase Utley grounds into the 5-4-3 double play. Braves 5, Phillies 2. So if the Braves and the Giants were to meet in the National League Championship Series, the Braves would have home field advantage. And Duane and Mike, I don't think the Giants really care, do you?
You know what, I don't, you know what, I think I'm a little disappointed we don't have to go to New York tomorrow. Or actually, is that, well, that would be tonight, wouldn't it?
Well, you know, you always like to have everything you could possibly get that would give your team an advantage. But bottom line is the Giants would better have a rested team and give up home field advantage than have a tired team and go into the first phase of the playoffs.
I thought what Peter McGowan said in the paper really hit the nail right on the head. The Marlins would be arriving into San Francisco tonight about the same time the Giants would be leaving for New York tonight. As Beltre pops this one to right field, it's hit well. Cruz back, and it's off the wall. Beltre will chug into second base with the double. So when you put it into that perspective, it's an easy decision to make if you're a player, a Giants player.
Yeah, in a trip like that, I'm not sure you ever really recover.
I mean, we still haven't recovered from the Montreal-New York trip.
Amen to that.
Where we had the blackout. I suppose it's quite possible that we may never recover just for the fact that we sat that long in Shea Stadium parking lot, which is low, 1-0.
Well, there's some funguses in that parking lot that they don't even have names for them.
2-0 to Bernitz. Yes.
Plus, you know, you assume this, too, is if you did go to New York, you played the game, and you come back home, you assume you're going to be able to have some kind of schedule that will be kept.
How about this?
Wow.
To Ray Durham and Beltre decided that, I don't know, not today. So he stays at second.
Adrian Beltre, I mean, you absolutely have to move up in that particular play. There's not a second baseman with a four-run lead in the world that would attempt to throw you out of third. Standard rule, ground ball to the right side of the infield, you go.
He had to have read that as a line drive, but nevertheless.
Just a base running mistake.
Yep.
And, I mean, you're talking about a 5-1 ball game in the first. A lot of game left to play for the Dodgers. If they could score in this inning, I mean, momentum-wise, they would gain a little bit back from that 4-run deficit. So that run out there at second base is very important.
Low to Ross. Ross hit a home run last night. His 10th of the year. Center field. Hammond's back. Beltre now will tag. Hammond makes the catch. And Beltre over to third.
So I mean, there's a run.
There is a run. Yeah.
And there's an RBI that David Ross doesn't get.
So now it'll be up to Cora to knock him in. Cora hitting 247, four home runs, 33 RBI. Knocking it down was Correa, but it's going to be an infield hit, and coming in to score is Beltre, and it's now 5-2.
And Alex Cora just picked up Adrian Beltre, because now the base running mistake is no longer an issue.
We've said this before about Kevin Correa. He really doesn't square up.
Well, like a lot of guys in this league, he throws and his momentum's going over towards the first base line. Very common for a right-handed pitcher. That ball hit to his right, he's not in any position to be able to get back to the ball. All he can do is just have that little swipe from behind. Ball hit his arm. No chance to get it to left.
Durham will charge it, and he will throw out Alvarez to end the inning. One run on two hits, one left. Giants are coming up 5-2 San Francisco. Alvarez to Aurelia in a swing and a miss, and it's 0-1. 5-2 Giants. Aurelia popped out in the first inning to David Ross, the catcher. Bonds to follow. Wind is blowing out today. High. One ball and one strike. There's the flags here at the ballpark. One pitch. Big bouncer. Beltre got eaten up. And Aurelia is going to beat it out.
Boy, that had some hair on it going down to Beltre. You knew that was going to be a tough play right off the crack of the bat.
Should be a hit.
Just get caught between bounces, and you got to try and play back. I mean, you know, the thing about it is if he comes up clean with that ball, he'd throw him out. He's got an exceptional arm, really with average speed at best. But that unpredictable hop coming up on him to the backhand, that's just a tough play.
Here's Bonds takes a ball, one ball and no strikes. Bonds with an RBI single in the first. And a strike at the knees, one ball and one strike. Shift is on to the right of second base is Touris.
Breaking ball.
Pulled down the line. This is a fair ball and it'll rattle around. Green digging it out and Aurelio is going to stop at third. And now the throw goes over everybody.
Alex Cora just airmailed one. And Aurelia will come in. Bonds will get to come home.
That's amazing right there.
Oh, I've seen it all now.
Well, he was up there looking breaking ball. Absolutely. Looked right through a 1-0 fastball right down the vein. On a 1-1 count, they give him the pitch he's looking for, rakes it down the line, and here's where Cora donates to the rally. Just a seed up into the stands. And the Giants pick up two.
There'll be no RBI.
This place is buzzing.
Yeah, it is. Alfonso, a home run in the first. Up high, two balls and no strikes. It's 7-2. Hammonds to follow. The 2-0 pitch to Alfonso is outside for a ball. Two balls in, or make it. Was it a ball? 3-0.
Looked like a pretty good pitch to me.
Plain umpire again. Doesn't work. Ball four.
Now this is the view from Bonds at bat right now, watching the reaction of the crowd. Here's the double. Now they start to gather a little momentum, and here's a throw from Cora. They got them up out of their chairs.
Jim Colburn is out.
Nice look to you, given to us by our cameraman Mike Muldowney out there. Well, as Jim Colburn talks it over with Wilson Alvarez, we'd like to remind you that the Giants Fantasy Camp 2004 will take place January 25th through February 1st in beautiful Scottsdale, Arizona. And you can enjoy 8 days at the Millennium Resort, play lots and lots of baseball at the Giants Spring Training Home. You go to Indian School Park, which is where they start their spring training, and you will also finish up, play games at Scottsdale Stadium. You can join Vita Blue, Gary Matthews, Bill Lasky, and many more of the Giants alumni. So call 1-800-SF-GIANT, menu 8, or visit us at giantscamps.com. Number again, 1-800-SF-GIANT, menu 8.
Those are my two picks 2 years ago.
Yep, a couple of A picks.
Hammond swings and fouls it back, and it's no balls and one strike. We are in the bottom of the second inning already. Out of play, nothing in two.
Well, so far it's been pretty entertaining.
I heard four oohs and ahs. That means it must have started out someplace and then along the way stopped briefly. Swing and a miss. So Hammonds is retired, first out. And the first strikeout in the game for Wilson Alvarez.
A little rattle around up there. You ooze, you ahs.
Cruz singled in the first inning. Right back to Alvarez. That's one, and that's two. So whatever Jim Colburn told Wilson Alvarez, it worked. Giants score two more, 7-2. Diamond is the world leader in culinary in-shell and snacky nuts. Try Diamond Glazed Snack Nuts, available in four delicious flavors that you go nuts for. Stop by the Diamond's Fresh Roasted Nut Carts located around Pac Bell Park. Diamond Nuts, they top everything. They have been a terrific sponsor this year right here on Fox Sports News. Thanks to the Diamond Nut folks. His tourists tried to bunt, and why not? He picked up a a bunt single to lead off the ball game and eventually came around to score. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-2. Cabrera and then Green to follow. Off the end of the bat. Nice play.
Nice pick. All right, Sandy Anthony. All over it. Pick it, lefty. Oh, yeah.
It was like not a problem.
It's not the first backhander she ever picked.
1-2.
Got him played, relaxed, not a problem. Reach down, look it into the glove, and never even cracked a smile. Automatic.
2-2.
Reyes shed the long sleeves he started this game with.
And into right field is Torres with a leadoff single. So it appears that this is not going to be an easy outing for Kevin Correa. Third inning in a row, the Dodgers have had their leadoff hitter aboard.
It's great being around young pitchers. It is, because you know, when you come up to the big leagues, when you first get here, you know, you think you have like the best stuff ever in the history of the game. Your fastball, whatever you bring into the game, you think you're proud of it. It got you here. Swing. And then you get out after it and you have a little success with it, and you start figuring, you know what, I got this down. I got it down. Yep. Well, the whole time you're getting it down, your opposition is studying you, and it takes you a while to realize that, guess what, you're not going to any other league. This is the league you've been trying to get to. There's no one beyond this. And you keep playing against the same guys year in and year out, and they're here for a number of reasons. One, they're good. And two, they're smart. And smart and good is a different deal, because your opposition starts to figure out a way to beat you. And
yeah, like every time up,
you realize that what you bring into the game is not enough. You have to be able to locate what you bring in the game. You have to be able to back off speeds of what you bring in the game. And you have to learn how to pitch. Jesse Fopper, one of the really bright young arms that have come out of the Giants organization in a long time. See the. That is the remnants of a surgery, a Tommy John surgery. Productive piece in his elbow, bandaged up, and he is on the mend. Going to miss all of next year with having that injury.
Two and two.
Good hard sink. But, you know, you really can't learn how to pitch the big leagues when you're pitching in double-A ball. I mean, you can learn some things about pitching, but when you get up here, it's you know, you have to identify and adjust, and then adjust again, and then adjust again.
Two-two pitch coming up. Up the middle, and a base hit past the diving Aurelia.
Well, a reminder that on the next Beyond the Glory, Evander Holyfield, who is the only boxer to match Muhammad Ali as a three-time heavyweight champion of the world, his story will be on Beyond the Glory, from his famous bite fight, Mike Tyson, to his mysterious heart disorder. Join us as we take you inside the hidden world of one of boxing's greatest stars, Evander Holyfield, Beyond the Glory, tonight at 9, right here on Fox Sports Net.
Sean Green. Two runners on for the Dodgers, and a foul out of play. Yep. Souvenir.
He earned that one. That had some fuzz on it.
He was on the phone.
Whoa. You wore it.
Bring your phone, get a ball.
Please.
Low, one ball and one strike. Like he actually stuck that left arm out and protected the guy that was sitting to his left.
Well, he got rewarded. He got to keep the ball.
Yeah, it doesn't always happen that way, does it? One and one to Green. Out of play, and it's one and two. And it was a dropped opportunity.
I'll think about that the rest of the day. All right, I know. I should have had it.
Yeah, boo me. Come on. Here it is. I've got it. Well, not an easy play.
That's right, though. He's styling. And when you're styling, life is good.
Not an easy play. I'm all right with that miss. One and two. Foul. Green looks at his bat. Oh, that cannot happen after you make a good play.
See, you see, that's why you laugh when you make a good play. I got it. And right through the wickets. Sandy Anthony. And she's taking some heat.
You're right. That's why you don't take a bow when you catch one.
And you smile when you catch one. Because you're going to smile when you don't.
Green out on strike.
That's nasty. A little change up there. A payoff pitch in a strikeout situation. Runner at second, nobody out. That's a strikeout situation, and he got it from a guy who's not easy to strike out. Change up, gets him looking, or gets him swinging way out of the zone. Now he's looking at it.
Oh, this was great. Ventura, did he hold up? They'll appeal, no swing, one ball and no strike. This was the good play, Sandy. That's when we were singing Sandy's praises.
Yeah, here's your evil twin right here. Oh, yeah.
She does have a twin, by the way.
Yes.
According to the notes here, she's got an identical twin.
Laura Elliott over there on the first base side. Sandy's got to feel like she's getting a little picked on.
Three and oh.
I got to say, our ball babes are looking pretty good today, though.
Yeah. And a strike, 3-1.
Ventura's going to make you work.
Ventura steps out, but not for long. Here's the pitch. Swing and a pop up. Durham and Snow and Cruz. Which one is it going to be? It's going to be Cruz who makes the catch. I think he was ever quite sure of that one.
Well, I think Ray Durham's real happy that it was Cruz that called him off. That would have been a very difficult play for the Giants second baseman.
Is that a you got it?
That's a you got it. Durham peels off. That's the sound he was waiting for. As an infielder, you go till called off and hope that you get called off.
Beltre doubled in the second. And the first pitch is high. One ball and no strikes. Giants with a 7-2 lead.
And the one pitch that Correa has not really established today, and that's that little slider that we've seen him throw that has been very impressive and hasn't got it going so far.
Swing and a miss. Beltre trying to make it 7-5. That is a beauty.
That's a gamer. How about the patch right across the chest?
The
National patch. League champions.
The whole outfit.
Who's the best baby?
Mom made that one. That little girl is being raised properly.
Foul back. 1-2.
That's a doll baby right there.
Very cute.
Oh, yeah.
Are you smiling?
She's going along with the program. To keep the hat on, man, that's a gamer.
Beltre in on his hands, and he dribbles it foul.
That thing just exploded into Beltre.
There's the blue bar.
Now, they're going to show this to this little girl in about 18 years.
It's a little big.
Meet brother
then she will have seen about 1,000 Giants
games.
That's
right. That's right. That's a good baby.
Nice going, Dad.
All right, Dad. Can you slow down?
You know, it's a kid. It ain't a blender. Let's go.
Got him. So, Correa allows two hits to start the inning off, and then he goes 1-2-3.
Unless the Dodgers' Kevin Brown comes on in relief and pitches six shutout innings today, which is not going to happen, Jason Schmidt is going to win the National League ERA title at 2.34. First Giant to do it since Billy Swift did it back in 1992. Our Bank of America Higher Standards looks at the National League Cy Young candidates. Schmidt, 17-5. Ortiz with a league-high 21 wins. Mark Pryor got his 18th win on yesterday. And, of course, Eric Gagne with 55 saves. One of those guys will be the lucky one who will win the National League Cy Young Award, guys.
All right, good stuff. So Yorvi Toriabo will face Steve Collier, the new Dodger pitcher.
Toriabo hitting with a protective piece right there on his left elbow where Alvarez got him in his first AB.
It's like Rich Aurelius.
That may be exactly what it is.
Inside corner strike, one ball and one strike. There's our Nextel Direct Connect brought to you by Nextel. The numbers for Steve Collier. 306 ERA, Collier. Saw some action yesterday. Cabrera now drifting back and he'll make the catch. Collier pitched one inning in game two. There's Kevin Correa. Yeah, young Turner Olsen doing the PA announcing. And Danville in the background. On the ground, this one is right at Ventura. And Correa is retired. Here he is. There you go. Check it out.
Number five.
All right, Turner, go get him.
Ray Duro!
That kid's got a future.
I think he's been practicing.
Absolutely. He's been up and down the Giants lineup. Could be a PA announcer someday, or a broadcaster, or a barker at North Beach.
Here's Ray Durham. And a strike. Durham in the first inning doubled and walked. Scored a run, knocked one in. Seven two Giants. And another strike to make it 0-2. Two outs here in the bottom of the third. And Durham out on three pitches. That'll do it. So a quick inning for the Dodgers. We'll head to the fourth. Burnett will lead it off 7-2. Giants.
Aflac trivia question.
Aflac.
You bet. Aflac trivia question. Can you name the last Giant to hit 340 or better in consecutive seasons?
Now, that's an easy one.
Get that one down?
Yeah. Here's Jeremy Burnett. Giants with a 7-2 lead. Burnett into left field. Bonds coming in. One pitch, one out. Actually, I have no idea.
You have no idea?
None whatsoever.
Well, I mean, if they count this year's effort, I mean, Bonds hit 339 coming in today's ballgame, has two hits. Last year hit 370, so he's going to be a qualifier.
Right. That's your call, huh?
Well, no, there's got to be somebody before him because he hasn't done it yet. He will.
David Ross hit a fly ball to center field. Outside and high. One ball and no strikes.
Beautiful day. Look out in the bay. You can see the reflection of the clouds out there on the water. Pretty nice.
2-0.
But what just kills me this time of year on a baseball field are the shadows. The shadows of fall coming across. It means playoffs.
That's Felipe Alou before the game for his radio show on KMBR. His surprises for this past season. There's a strike. He said Williams, Correa, Foppert, Nathan. I might have missed another young pitcher in there somewhere.
Ainsworth.
Ainsworth. There's a walk to David Ross. He said, in as many veteran players as we have, we could not have done it without those names. He said even Damian Moss won, what did he win, 6-7 games?
Yeah.
First pitch to Alex Cora is a strike. He also said that he was told immediately by the coaches and Brian Sabian that this division, the West, would be the toughest division. There's a base hit to right field. Moving down to second is Ross, and Correa is in trouble again. The ball shot right by Richard Reed.
Moss won 9 games.
9. There you go. He said, so for this team to play as well as it has in their division, Giants are 52-23 in the West. He said that was another surprise. Here's Collier. Collier does not have a hit this year. As a matter of fact, according to the numbers, he hasn't even come to the plate. And he bunts through it, throw down to second, and had it been a good throw, they'd have had him. Toriyama's throw sailed to the right of second base, and that saved David Ross.
Now let's watch it all unfold. See Aurelio sneaking in behind. That's what Toriyama saw. And you're right, if that's to the shortstop side of second base.
See how he's get that right arm caught underneath?
He's doing a belly crawl back to the bag.
Low, one ball and one strike. Boy, it is full as Giants fans are hanging from the rafters today. Tuesday. Big day here in San Francisco. Giants and Marlins at 1 o'clock. There's a bunt, and it's foul, and it's 1-2.
You know, it's good to see John Kibler. John Kibler was an umpire for many, many years in the National League, and he was there when we were players. Son Jeff, we see a lot. John Kibler came into the booth today, and he looked great. Had the flat top butch haircut he always had as an umpire. And this was his first time here at Packville Park. And he couldn't wait to see it. Just moved to Palo Alto to be closer to his boys.
Two and two. And now it's 3-2. So Correa did not want to do that. Three and two. And he walked him. So Correa walks the pitcher. Before the game, the Giants players, manager, and coaches honored Barney Nugent, who is retiring at the end of this season. Rich Aurelia spoke on behalf of the players. Stan Kenny, of course, spoke on behalf of the training staff. Barney Nugent, a terrific employee for the Giants, an excellent trainer, is going to retire. And the training staff and players, a gift to Barney and Denise. A ticket for two to anywhere they want to go. How about that?
Well, Barney's going to Sacramento.
And Denise is going to London. So Denise, make sure you send Barney a postcard in Sacramento. Bases are loaded for Cesar Asturias. Not close. One ball and no strike.
This has really been confusing for Correa. The last three starts.
That's a base hit. One run will come in. It's now 7-3, and the bases stay loaded. And now the big fellas start to come up. His Torres is 3-for-3.
And what's been confusing is that he has always been a guy who's had command of his pitches. And now he's not. He's kind of at the mercy of the strike zone. He's just trying to throw a strike. He's not trying to think inside, outside, work a corner. He's trying to say, I just want to throw a strike. And that's a tough way to pitch, because when you lose that type of ability to command your pitches to a corner and you got to go across the middle of the plate, you're going to get hit. Then you have to get lucky, and that hit has to find somebody.
And Carrera takes a breaking ball in tight.
And the one pitch that he has really been without is that good, tight, little hard breaking slider. It has not showed up. Noah Lowry started to get loose for Felipe Alou.
Foul at the plate. One ball and one strike.
Slider's kind of a temperamental pitch. It can go. John Johnstone used to go in and out with a slider, and he'd have a slider one day, and then he'd have one that did. It just would spin like a slider. Wouldn't it go straight? We'd call it the cement mixer. I think that, to a degree, is what's happened to Correa. It's spinning, but it ain't breaking.
Maybe a double play ball, Aurelia. To Durham. To Snow. Got him as Snow digs it out. So Correa does give up a run, but he dodges a bullet after that. 7-3
Giants. 7-3
Giants.
We're in the bottom half of the fourth inning. Time now for our Pennzoil protection play. Pennzoil, we're driving protection. And they call it the pitcher's best friend, and we'll show you why. Gilbert Cabrera coming up, bases loaded, one out. Dodgers threatening to get right back in it, and a broken bat jam shot off a sinker right on the hands to Aurelia, to Durham, to Snow, dug out of the dirt. A 6-4-3 double play. That is our Pennzoil protection play. It kills the threat. It minimizes the damage. And the Giants still lead this ballgame 7-3. And Kevin Correa could take a deep breath. That was our Pennzoil protection play.
So Collier now will face JT Snow. Richard William, Barry Bonds. Bottom of the fourth. Snow is 0 for 2. Made both outs in the first inning. He hit two fly balls to center field. Oh and one. Low to Snow. One ball and one strike. Giants with 8 hits. The Dodgers with 7. Snow takes a strike. A little breaking ball breaking away from Snow. 1-2.
Collier was a closer in Las Vegas this year. He's got some pretty good pop in his fastball. This is 90-94-ish. Big curveball.
Snow's got a base hit. Nice hitting right back up the middle.
Yeah, and that was not an easy pitch either. That was no hanger. He beat a pretty good pitch. JT goes to first base. We're going to ask and answer our athletic trivia question. Our question today: can you name the last Giant to hit 340 or better in consecutive seasons? Our survey said. Yeah, see, Bill Terry did it.
Right.
Barry Bonds is going to join him this year.
This season, 342. Aurelia takes a strike. Rich Aurelia. Popped out in the first and then singled in the second. Seven, three Giants. Up high. Rich Aurelia on Friday night. The first inning, 3-run home run. And that gave Aurelia 13 on the year. Fouled off the mask of either Ross or Meals. 1-2. Aurelia taking his time. Bonds on deck. One and two. And Aurelia is out on strikes on a breaking ball low and in. How's your second strikeout? This is what's going on with Barry Bonds as far as the home runs. He needs 2 to tie his godfather. 56. To tie Ruth and 97 to tie Hank Aaron. 658 total. And he's at the plate with Snow at first. Low and away. One ball and no strike.
You know, I think Collier's got the kind of breaking ball that you're sort of disadvantaged as a hitter when you haven't seen it for the first time. It's a good breaking ball.
2-0.
It's amazing how the new fans here at Packville Park are training. Bonds gets a 2-0 count, automatically start booing.
Yeah, if they sniff a walk, they're ready to twirl those rubber chickens. Down the left field line, that's going to be a foul ball.
96 mile an hour challenge fastball from Collier. Now that's the best fastball we've seen that lefty throw. He is not topped out over 94. And again, it's Bonds that gets the added electricity on the fastball.
Two and one. Three balls and one strike to Barry Bonds. And there's that chorus of boos that Mike was talking about. Edgardo Alfonso waits on deck. Here's the 3-1. Bonds out of play. This one was at 97.
Wow.
So that kind of surprises me.
Well, yeah, I mean, I was telling us this guy's got a good fastball. He'd get up there on 93, 94. We've only seen a few 94s, but Bonds, he's taking this guy to new levels. 96, 97. I mean, that's not a good fastball. That's a great fastball.
3-2. Swing and a miss. Throw down to second, and Snow's going to steal it. That whole play was in slow motion after Bonds struck out.
97 mile an hour challenge fastball right at the belt, and Collier sits Mr. Bonds down.
Forget about closing with this guy. Start him.
Well, I know one thing. That will be remembered. That at bat right there will be remembered over this winter. We're going to start to talk about next year's roster.
It's precisely why you said on Friday night during our open as to why in this series wouldn't you pitch to Bonds if you're the Dodgers.
You've got to find out. And Steve Collier just gained a little reputation right there. I mean, if you're a team in the National League West, you have to find a left-hander for your bullpen that can get Bonds out. I mean, Jesse Orozco's been in this league for probably the last 12 years to be able to do just that. The first 13, he was here on ability. The last 12 was to get out Bonds. We tease Jesse. He's had a brilliant career. But he has hung around a long time to be the left-handed specialist, not just Bonds, but Helton. Just a lot of guys in the National League who are power lefties.
Outside to Alfonso. Alfonso hit a two-run home run in the first. One ball and one strike. High and away, 2-1. Snow is first steal of the year, and it comes during the last regular season game. Swing and a miss. 2-2.
Good location with a 2-1 fastball right above the hands to a guy who's quick middle in. You beat a guy on the side of the plate that he prefers, you made a good pitch.
Two balls, two strikes. Up high. Now it's 3-2. So Edgardo Alfonso with the two RBIs in the first inning jumped him over the 80 mark for runs batted in. 3-2. Bottom of the fourth inning. And Alfonso out on strike. So after the Snow single, Collier strikes out the side. He's got 4-2 innings. Well, here at Pac-Val Park, on-deck seating plan, it's the best access to the best season tickets that become available. And it's only $200 per seat. Now, if you need more information on how to go about doing this, call this number at 415-972-2298.
Now play third base and batting fourth. number 50, Todd Linden.
There's the first pitch down the left field line, and that's a fair ball. Sean Green on the first pitch is going to put Correa in trouble immediately.
Right back on the stretch, you saw Todd Linden, who's just coming to the game at left field, replacing Barry Bonds, who has called it a day. And immediately the ball finds him. Pedro Feliz is coming to play third base. Edgardo Alfonso taking the rest of the day off. And they've gotten some at bats. They are sharp and they are ready to go to the playoffs. So Barnes and Alfonso out of the game.
With the exception of the fourth inning, the Dodgers have had the leadoff hitter on first, second, third, and now the fifth. Here's Robin Ventura, 7-3 Giants. Fifth inning. And the pitch is outside. Ventura struck out in the first, popped out to right field in the third. Swing and a miss. Changeup, one ball and one strike.
I think basically he's out there with the fastball and the changeup today, and the slider has kind of been unpredictable for him. And it's been a struggle for him.
And a strike. One and two.
One thing about Correa, though, and I like this about him, he's got a real good makeup, which is one of the reasons he's come up quickly. He never really lets the opponents or his teammates let him see him sweat. Nothing seems to rattle the kid.
Just a bit inside.
It's close. Good pitch there.
Two and two. Good look at Green as he takes his lead. Swing and a miss. He struck him out.
So Robin Ventura's got to be impressed with the changeup from Correa. That's the second time he struck out. An 0-for-3 from Ventura. And here's the payoff pitch. A good changeup. Get right out after it, and it just falls right off the plate.
That is a good one. Here's Beltre. Double in the second. Struck out in the third. Now at the plate with Green at second. One out. Pop up. Middle of the diamond. Snow usually likes to take these. Two outs. Here's Bernitz. Bernitz, swing and a miss, and it's 0-1. Now we should congratulate the new member to the Giants family, Sarah Rose Zerbe, born this morning at 4:37, 5 pounds 9 ounces, to Rachel and Chad Zerbe. So that house will never be the same.
Nope.
And congratulations, and we understand all are doing well.
Pretty exciting day.
It is an exciting day.
Especially your first one. You have no idea what's in store for you.
There's a little dribbler out in front of the plate. Correa has it. He will flip it to Snow, and he gets out of it again. No runs, a hit, one left. Giants are coming up. 7-3 San Francisco.
Bottom of the fifth inning. Well, the Boston Red Sox are headed to the postseason. They will play the Oakland A's starting on Wednesday night. And we want to send out a congratulations to Red Sox third baseman Billy Miller. Billy Miller won the American League batting title. He finished with a 326 average, finished 1 point ahead of his teammate Manny Ramirez. That 326 average was the lowest average to win a batting title in 31 years. I don't think Bill Miller cares. Duane and Mike, he's one of our favorites, isn't he?
Doesn't care as Hammonds lines this one to Kincaid and left. And Shuey's first pitch is an out. So Kincaid is now the new left fielder, and Shuey is the new pitcher, and the numbers for Shuey. Absolutely not. Bill Miller didn't care if he had 286 and led the American League in hitting.
No. And you know what? Him leading the American League in hitting is not a surprise. But what is a surprise is Manny Ramirez went into the last day hitting 325, didn't play.
Did not play.
What's up with that?
There's a bunt by Cruz. And Cruz is going to... No! I thought for sure he had it beat out, but I'm not going to argue with Chris Cuccioni. He probably got it right.
You know what? I don't even care if he got it right. That's about as brilliant a play at third base as you could make on a bunt play. This is just spectacular. You talk about out of control. What makes this play unique is the speed that he comes into the ball with and how he still manages to get balanced enough to make a throw. That's just fantastic. And I think he may have beaten it out. Who cares? This is fun to watch. Adrian Beltre, he may be the best at it. Wow.
I think he is. I don't think anybody makes that play better than he does.
I mean, he is just coming on that ball fast. I mean, that's the thing, the speed to the ball. That's what. And normally you get the ball that quick, and you can, there's no way you can get balance to get a throw on it.
Toyaba fouls it out of play. It's 0-2.
Great play.
Very, very nice play. I wouldn't bunt on him.
After looking at that, I wouldn't bunt on him.
I just wouldn't do it. In the dirt, 1-2.
I mean, watch how fast he's coming to the ball. I mean, how do you get in command of your body to get off a throw and get enough on it and with an accuracy?
Big bouncer to Beltre. That will end the inning. Shuey with a quick inning. We've played five. Sixth inning coming up. 7-3 Giants.
Time now for Carl's Jr. In Your Face. And for today's In Your Face, we go to David Ross, the big catcher for the Dodgers. Took a little bit too much lead out there at second base, and Yervi Torrealba almost picked him up. But we like the effort from Ross getting back to the bag. He a little belly crawl, and he just avoids the tag. That, to us, qualifies as a Carl Jr. In Your Face.
Yeah. A little Velcro underneath that arm trying to get back. All right, David Ross will lead it off. Ross, Carrera, and then Kincaid, who came in on the double switch. And the first pitch to Ross is low. One ball and no strike. Cody Ransom is at short. Aurelia out. Lance Nieker was at first. And the pitch, and it's low, and it dribbles to the backstop, and it's two balls and no strikes. Three runs on eight hits for the Dodgers, seven runs on nine hits for the Giants. Two and oh. Big bouncing ball past Feliz. That'll roll over the bullpen mound. Linden will wait till the ball comes to him, and Ross is going to go into second base with another leadoff double. And with Ross standing on second, we'd like to introduce our boss, Mr. Larry Bear, which means we will be on our best behavior for the next couple of minutes. Welcome, Larry.
As if you aren't always on your
best
behavior.
We're trying to be on our best behavior, but sometimes I have trouble controlling my partner, but of course we feel like, you know, we have things under control. So what brings Mr. Bear into the booth today?
Well, it's for a thank you. And, you know, there's been a lot of discussion about the team and Felipe, and as well there should be, because it's been an amazing year for everybody in Giants uniform, but it's also been yet another amazing year for the Giants fans. And this year we again lead the league in attendance, 3.265, I think, is where we're going to end up, million. And that is, I have to say, that is really quite an accomplishment. And we talked a lot when the ballpark was being built about how you know, we felt that this was a baseball town. We just needed the right park. And, boy, the fans have really proved that out. And it's been an amazing accomplishment. And I have to say, Mike and Duane, that, you know, without our fans, we would not be able to be achieving what we're achieving.
Now, what would that line be?
And what that line is the line for tickets for that go on sale tomorrow for the league championship series, not the series that begins Tuesday against Florida. But if we're fortunate enough to get by Florida, then we are going to, tomorrow at 10 a.m., these tickets, people in line there are going to be buying tickets for, they go on sale tomorrow at 10 o'clock for the league championship series. Now, you can also avoid that line and attempt to get tickets through our website or through the phones. I am not going to sit here and encourage people to necessarily come down here and spend the night in line. I think that, you know, probably the easiest way to do it would be to get on the phone tomorrow or get on the website and try to get tickets for the league championship series.
Here it's 3-2 to Alex Cora with Ross at second base. Nobody out. We're visiting with Larry Bear on the final regular season game. And also I might add that and we don't like to walk around saying, hey, our ratings are great, but the ratings for our games this year have been very good on TV.
Well, you know, what's really refreshing is those who can't get to the ballpark, and we have a lot of sellouts, are really tuning in huge numbers. We're finding, Kipe, that most nights during the spring and summer, Giants baseball, either on Fox Sportsnet or on KTVU, is the best rated show on. And that's a really, you know, quite a testimony to our fans, to the club, and I must say to the two of you guys and to our incredible crew in the truck, Jim Lynch and Jeff Kuiper and the group. Amazing work. And it just doesn't happen. You don't flip a switch and have the kind of audiences that we have.
Kincaid takes the strike. First and second. Nobody out. 7-3 Giants leading. Correa once again trying to wiggle his way out of it. And he might do it. There's a double play ball. Ransom will take it himself. And Nitro digs it out. And they get the double play. Two outs.
Not an easy double play. Alex Cora was putting some pretty good heat on Ransom at second base. And Ransom had the play right in front of him, opting to take it himself rather than go to an exchange with Durham.
That was a triple-A double play right there. Correa threw it, and the fellas took care of it behind him.
Yes, indeed. And that's going to wind it up, I think, for the day for Kevin Correa.
Felipe's coming out, and he will take the ball, and Kevin Correa is going to depart under a nice round of applause. 7-3, Giants are leading. We'll be back to visit with Larry Bear and check out Noah Lowry right after this.
Okay, the Giants have announced that tickets for possible National League Championship Series will go on sale to the general public tomorrow, Monday, September 29th, beginning at 10 a.m. on a first-come, first-served basis. Tickets are also available through the Giants website at sfgiants.com or by phone at 510-762-2277. Now, they will be available for purchase in person only at the Pacific Bell ticket office. The Pac Bell Park ticket office will allow you to purchase 4 tickets for each game played at Pacific Bell Park. Between 5,000 and 7,000 tickets will be offered, so hopefully you can get some.
Now, Felipe Alou couldn't wait to get Cesar Asturias turned around. Batting right-handed, left-handed, 3-for-3 today. So now facing Noah Lowry. And a pop-up to left field. Linden battling the sun, and now it's a bit more than a pop-up as it drifts out into left center, and that ends the inning. No runs, a hit, a walk, but a huge double play ball. 7-3 Giants.
On tap for the Giants, brought to you by Corona and the NLDS, starting Tuesday against the Florida Marlins. Game one will be at 1 o'clock every day the Giants are on. They're on Tuesday, Wednesday at 1 o'clock, and Friday in Florida at 1 o'clock.
A loud foul off the bat of Noah Lowry, who just unloaded on
him. He can rake.
No, Lowry hits one to left.
How about this?
He hits it well, and he hits it off the wall. And Lowry is going to be held to the longest single of the year. But who cares? He almost hit one out.
It's his first big league hit.
And
you're not worthy.
And his first major league at bat.
Save the ball. The ball just went over to the dugout.
I'll tell you what, that won't be his last big league hit. He can hit. I mean, this is a good hack. That is, it looks like Jeff Kent.
It did.
And he almost puts it out of here. Oh, third of the way up the wall. And he goes right to a trot.
Easy, big fella. This is the big leagues now.
That's amazing.
Here's Eric Young. And Young takes low. It's also off of Paul Shuey, who is no day at the beach.
Yeah, Paul Shuey, I mean, Shuey comes into this game and got an ERA of 2.82. He's only given up 6 home runs all year, and he almost gives up Lowry's first hit, which is a single but could have been a homer, almost. Any other ballpark in America would have been a home run. Stuff to
tell you.
Yeah. Barney Nugent is going to write some very obscene things on that baseball. There's a strike.
Barney retiring after 11 seasons as a Giants assistant athletic trainer.
Boy, it's hard to see a member of the family go, you know, and Barney and Denise are going to have a great time in retirement, but there are a lot of moist eyes seeing Barney go in our pregame ceremony. He's been a rock. He's been part of the family for, 11 years now.
Barney's been one, he's one of those characters. Number one, he's very good at what he does, but number two, he's one of those guys that if you don't want the answer, don't ask Barney, because he is not going to beat around the bush.
Young fouls this one at the plate. So Lowry now is something that Hermanson doesn't have this year. Nathan, Worrell, and Zerbe, and that's a hit. And it might not be a good idea for Noah Lowry to mention that as he walks through the clubhouse after the game. A little pop-up, and it's going to be out of play.
That nine spot's been hot for the Giants today. Kevin Correa had a knock in the first inning, drove in a run, second of the year. Now Lowry gets his first big league knock.
Barney was writing an essay on that ball. Well, what's he writing, Chris?
Well, he'll put something in there like, a doink base hit off of Puss Ballard, Paul Shuey, and it's never very complimentary to the guy that threw it or the guy that hit it. You know, of course, he'll misspell Noah Lowry.
Yeah. First base hit off of Huey Lewis, Lowry, Shuey. I mean, there'll be stuff on there that you cannot show any members of your family. On the ground, Beltre. Nice backhand play and a high throw. And Young is going to be called safe, and I think they got that wrong.
I did too. He took a turn in.
Yes, he did.
First base umpire Chris Guccione hearing a little argument from Robin Ventura as the ball went over the head of Ventura. The Dodgers catch a break as the ball comes back right to Ventura. And they lose the bag to third base with Lowry coming over. But right here's where they catch the break. And look at the turn in. If you make any turn in towards the towards second base, you can be tagged out.
And it all has to be is a little shoulder turn.
And that's what it was. No argument from Jim Tracy or the Dodgers bench, and it'll stay.
Here's Lance Niekro. So Niekro batting for the first time. He's looking for his first big league hit. He's 0 for 3. Young goes, swing and a miss. Here's the throw down to second, and the ball gets away from Cora, but Young has a stolen base.
Can't forget about him. Eric Young, the base stealer, he will sense opportunity, and if you don't pay attention to him, as Paul Shuey kind of forgot about him.
And a swing and a big bouncer foul. Here's Kirk Reeder. He said, Barney, I can't read your handwriting. What does that say?
It says, Puss Baller.
Infield will play in for the Dodgers. Nobody out. 7-3 Giants.
It's great. You know, they've been doing that thing with the ball for years. Get a dummy ball and dress it up. The real ball, of course.
Base hit!
Necro's got his first big league hit, his first big league double, and his first big league RBIs, and it's 9-3.
And Barney knew he's going to get another ball. And Mr. Necro, he got yourself a batting average. And that's a ball I bet he sends to his old man.
Yep, I bet you're right.
Well, Paul Shue's giving him first big league knocks left and right. And what Necro does well is use the right side of the field. He's a great gap-to-gap hitter. And you'll see a lot of these. Boy, he stayed on the ball. Head stayed still. He's a doubles hitter. And he just proved it.
Here's Cody Ransom.
There goes Barney again.
Oh, he'll be
back to work.
Barney just a couple of pins.
Ran out of ink. Here, Greg, let me have your pen. Strike to Ransom.
You know, I noticed them giving high fives to Lowry when he came in the dugout. I used to read about the silent treatment they give guys after their first knock. Is that gone by the wayside?
You see it once in a while. It's too good to just completely can.
Yeah.
Usually it's the first big league home run, though.
Okay.
There's a strike, and it's 0-2 to Ransom. 240. Six hits, 25 at-bats. Barney back at work. Barney trying to come up with more cute stuff for the baseball. On the dirt, jogging over to third will be Necro. Now, if you're the Dodgers, this is one of those games where you have to be really careful that it doesn't get ugly, ugly, ugly.
No, you're right. I mean, the emotion in this game for the Dodgers is out. They're playing out the schedule, and they're thinking about the offseason. They're thinking about everything but the baseball game.
I think it's a treat for the fans to be able to get a glimpse at the future in a game where, last game of the regular season, where Giants could notch their 100th win.
Up and in to Ransom.
Get a lot of questions about Lance Necro. Obviously a great baseball legacy with his family, and it's great to see him at the big league level having a chance.
2-2. Swing and a miss. Ransom out. And Pedro Feliz is coming up.
I mean, winning 100 ball games, it doesn't happen very often. The Giants would win today. It would be their 7th 100 win season in franchise history, first since 1993. When the Giants won 103 and didn't win the division, of course.
Could you believe that?
Yeah.
In today's world, in professional sports, you know, here we are 11 years later, or 10 years later, I guess, but you win 103 games, second best record in all of baseball that year, and you don't go to the playoffs. So those who don't like the wild card, think about that a little bit.
Green moving back. Green looking up. It's off the wall. Feliz may be digging for three. He's got an RBI, and he is going to go in with a triple. 10-3.
What he does so well is go the other way with power. He starts wide, he plants wide, but he still stays inside the ball. That ball had backspin. Just a great show of power off the wall in right field. And that's going to bring out Jim Colburn, the pitching coach for the Dodgers.
This is a year to remember. Wire to wire, ninth team to do it. Pacville Park record at home for 56 wins. And the consecutive appearances for the Giants, that's the first time that's happened since 1936-1937. Larry, before we send you away, which of course we wouldn't do, seeing as how you're our boss, but it was possible the Giants would be going to New York after the game. And that would have happened had the Major League Baseball decided against it, because of the Giants would have trailed the Braves by a half
That's
a
right.
game after today.
You know, that was one we've been scratching our heads about for about 3 weeks. And there was no good solution. And I think that, quite frankly, you know, the commissioner's office and others were kind of hoping the problem would just go away, that it would get settled by, you know, one team, the Giants and Braves, separating themselves. It didn't happen. And I think that really the right solution was reached, and that is that you can't disadvantage yourself in the first round in order to get a possible advantage in the second round.
Right.
And that was one where really the management of the club and the manager and the players and the coaches were all in sync. Nobody felt that it was to our benefit. And I think then the discussions with the league, the New York Mets were not wild about playing the game either, I might add. So the whole thing didn't really make sense. And I think the right outcome was arrived at, although I got to tell you, it was maybe two or three calls a day for several weeks to try to hash it out.
Right.
We're in a situation where literally, and it was reported in the paper, where we could have been flying out as the Marlins were flying in tonight, we'd be flying out. And that's just not a good, that's not something good to envision.
So it worked out.
It all worked out. Might add, Duane, saw some folks with a t-shirt saying Orange October. We are asking fans as they come to games this week that they can wear orange and create kind of an orange effect inside the ballpark. There are a couple of them today in their orange. And it's okay if you wear orange on September 30th as well. It could be Orange October plus one, since the first game will be Tuesday, September 30th.
All right, good idea.
Day baseball.
Jeffrey Hammonds to face Paul Shuey. Three runs in here in the sixth. Hammonds takes a strike. Hammonds 1-for-3. So Shuey has given up three runs. Not all of them will be earned. Big bouncing ball foul. 0-2. Well, there's the two kids that came up with their first big league hits here in the sixth inning. Swing and a miss. Shuey fell down, and Hammond strikes out, and we'll thank Larry Bear. Larry, thanks for coming by.
Thanks a million. Thanks again to the fans for all that they've done this year to get us to where we are.
All right, we'll be back. Giants lead 10-3. Six innings. Take a look at our Chevron High Performance Spotlight. How did the Giants do against the Marlins this year? In six games, the Giants went 5-1. Giants hit better, scored more runs, had a couple of more extra base hits, and they pitched better. And let me be the first one to say,
yes,
throw all of those out the window.
Oh, yeah.
Forget
exactly
about
right.
It. But it does give you an idea how well the Giants did play against Florida. There's Torcato now in left field, and moving from left to right is Todd Linden. Since Jack McKeon was hired, no one had a better record in Major League Baseball than the Marlins. Giants played their first three games in Florida with Jeff Torborg as the manager. And then when Florida came here in August, that's when McKeon was managing. Nice play. A redeemer.
All right. All right. Sandy Anthony, that is your redeemer. That ball had some fuzz on it, too.
Yes, it did.
All right. Pick it. Yep. I got it. Not a problem.
So Noah Lowry facing Olibert Cabrera. Look out. Ransom. Necro got him on the slide. As Lowry jumped about 3 feet to avoid the broken bat. So safe to say this was not a routine play by anybody.
No, a little jam sandwich here. The bat gets going right back up towards Lowry, who just had a little high step. But the play here made from both ends of it. Ransom a nice pick, and then Lance Necro ad-libbing to put the tag on as Cabrera came crashing on a slide down the first baseline.
Green takes a strike. Sean Green, an RBI, a double, 1-for-3. And he rolls it foul.
That's a good changeup right there. Lowry's got a real high three-quarter release.
Fastball, curveball, changeup, and I think his changeup is a pitch that he will not hesitate to throw at any time.
Out of play. Yep. What is that, Mike?
Nice yards, people.
I don't know that. I don't know about the hat, though.
Yep, wear your orange.
A high fastball, 1-2.
You know, it's great, though. I mean, you come to Packville Park, and it's the Giants fans. But this is it. This is their home.
Torcato. All right, let's check in with Glenn.
Thanks, Wayne. Well, I have the ball, the fake ball, that was given to Lance Hecker after his first major league hit. And this is what it says. First major league hit at Pac Bell Park, a bleeder between second and short. You hit it like your dad used to pitch it. That was from Barney Nugent.
See, there's no sugarcoat there.
Well, in reference to the fact that Joe threw a lot of knuckleballs. I'm wondering if, does Glenn know if Lance actually saw it? One ball and one strike to Ventura in the dirt. So Barney doing his work. He's working overtime.
Yeah, he's having fun with it.
That's why we've always said September can be fun. 2-2 to Ventura, who really had enough of seeing changeups today.
September's fun if you're in first place.
Up high, 3-2. Orange to the ballpark. Starting on Tuesday. Up and in to Ventura in a two-out walk. Which means break out your Halloween stuff if you don't have any Giants on.
You know, I was saying, though, I mean, it's pretty neat. Yeah. Giants fans have totally dictated policy as to what fans do and how they dress and how they come to this ballpark, and they show their colors. It is their house, and they treat it as such.
Beltre fouls it back.
It's so much fun to see the different versions of how a fan can show their colors. And it changes day to day. And everybody's into it, and I love it.
Beltre hits it foul. Shot right into the dugout. Jerome Williams ended up with it. No, actually, Jerome's looking at the ball. He thinks this is pretty funny.
Yeah. He got me, so now it's funny when they get somebody else. Nico finally sees it, he goes,
okay, I hit it like, what?
Like my dad used to throw it.
1-2. Got him. Giants are coming up. 10-3 San Francisco.
Giants. We're in the bottom half of the seventh inning. Here is our Bank of America Higher Standard. Barry Bonds earlier this year reached a milestone that nobody ever did in Major League history. He stole his 500th base. That made him a 600-500 guy. He did it against Eric Gagne June 23rd of this year. And that is our Bank of America Higher Standard. One of the great memories of the 2003 season.
Well, I can tell we have some changes. And we'll pass those along when we figure out who they are.
Well, we know we have a new pitcher.
And we think that's Tom Martin. Ventura looks like he's at third. We know that's Felipe Alou. He is the manager of the Giants. And so Ventura is at third. Coomer is at first. Jason Romano is now in right field. And the numbers for Tom Martin.
Eighth game of the year for Tom Martin. I think that's a milestone for a reliever. Says that you've been out there a lot.
So Tony Torcato. Will be the first hitter that Martin faces. And Torcato lifts it into center field. Cabrero coming in, still coming in, and Cabrero with a sliding catch and a nice one to get out number one. They put an exclamation point behind that play.
Well, this was not an easy play coming in to a backhand on a slide. Looking right into the sun. Good concentration. Some style points on the slide. Big league play. Nice pick.
Here's your Vitor Alba. Vitor Alba takes a pitch up high. Vitor Alba at 261. He does not have a hit in this game. He was hit by a pitch in the first. And a big bouncer to short is Turris. To Coomer, two outs. And that'll bring up Noah Lowry. Well, the book is out on Lowry.
He can hit.
And, there will be no lollipops thrown into Mr. Lowry. He singled in the sixth. Had a little step in the bucket on that one.
Here was that first big league hit off of Paul Shuey, and that in itself is doing something. And he almost pumped it out of here.
There's a strike, one ball and one strike.
I think that'll be the last pitch he takes in the strike zone.
Outside, Alvarez, Collier, Shuey, now Martin. Three of the four pitchers today have been left in. Swing and a miss. Two and two.
But they're flailing. Good things happen when you swing.
On the appeal, no swing. Lowry, easy big fella.
It's ball three, meat.
Oh, that's going to get some smiles from the Giants dugout.
Yep, did he go? No, okay,
yeah.
I'm taking my base.
See you later. And I am really cool about it. Here's the pitch. He struck him out. That's my fifth favorite at bat of the year. 10-3.
Guys, baseball on Fox Sports Net. Receive a gift of Nike eyewear.
All right. So you wonder why we like rookies? Here's why. Here it is.
I'll just take my walk. Okay.
He does the holster thing, right? Yeah. See ya.
I'm bad.
I am just a cool dude.
Oh, it's the best.
10-3 Giants. We love them.
Yeah, rookies make you laugh, man.
On the ground, that's a fair ball, police. Nitro, one out. Yeah, he's kind of got that grin like, yeah, I just took some candy, and you caught me. And you got to remember, he is a left-hander.
Yeah. See, some guys get a mulligan for their career. Lefties get a mulligan a game. And that's the difference.
You know what? That is so true. Here's Ross. Outside to Ross. One ball and no strikes. Out like a light, but in a good spot.
Oh, yeah. I don't know who enjoys that more. The sleeper or mom?
Yep, you're exactly right. It's one of the things I'm sure your wife and my wife miss.
I miss it.
That's why you could never style when you had kids that age, because there was always a drool spot somewhere on your shirt.
Not a problem. Dad badge. You're in those.
Yep. 2-1. 3-1.
Having dog drool on you just ain't the same deal.
Yeah. Mom's doing okay right there.
Nice quiet moment.
Foul down the left field line. There's a good lap to sit on.
Yep, Grandpa.
No, I don't think I'd mess with Grandpa.
No, Grandpa's got some guns. Like he's been riding a fire truck for like the last 40 years.
Do not think I'd arm wrestle Grandpa. Center field, Hammonds comes jogging in, and he will make the catch. And with two outs, here's Alex Cora.
Sweet ride right there. I think Catherine Hepburn should be sitting right there.
Yeah.
Back into that thing.
Alex Cora has two singles and a walk. And Lowry throws him a strike. Eighth inning, Giants with a 10-3 lead. Two balls and one strike. Hard Marty behind the camera. Very close, 3-1. Left field, Torcato, glasses down. Torcato dropped it. Torcato did everything right, except hold on to it, and of course he is looking into the sun.
Tough play, put the glasses down, swings over. Got a lot of glove on it. Whoop.
So Kincaid will bat for the second time. And Kincaid could not hold up, and it's no balls and one strike. Oh, and one. That hit Kincaid. So Kincaid down to first. And his tourist will come up.
It's a little cutter that just sort of bore in on him. Right off the thigh. Kincaid definitely the kind of guy will take one for the team. Not a problem. Although it's a rough at bat if it's the last one you're going to have all
yeah.
year.
up high is Turris. As Brouwer jogs down to the bullpen, as Turris is 3-for-3, batting left-handed, right-handed, 0-for-1. He hit a fly ball off of Lowry in the sixth. 2-0. All right.
Look at, there you are.
Oh, yeah. She's definitely wide-eyed, bright-eyed, ready to rip.
Look at him just following.
That's all you got to do is let them recharge, and they're ready to go.
Dave Rigetti out to talk to Lowry. Lowry rubbing up the baseball. An old lefty talking to a young one. Although I would say different styles.
Well, yeah. Noah Lowry is a guy who I think is going to be pitching around that changeup because it's a good one. Dave Rigetti, I'm not sure he ever had a changeup.
Know how to hold one.
It was just here. I mean, he was 98, 99 mile an hour lefty with outstanding fastball slider combo.
Here's the 2-0, and it's low, and it's 3-0. Lowry needs to come in with a strike. He does, 3-1.
Hey, congratulations to Detroit.
Yeah, did they get a win today?
They won today. They beat Minnesota.
So they ended up with 119 losses. Pop up. Ransom. And that ends the inning. Dodgers strand a pair. 10-3 Giants.
At bottom half of the eighth inning. Let's take a look at our Bank of America Higher Standard. And last night, Jose Cruz provided the moment. It was a three-run shot in the eighth inning, and that was the difference in the ball game. The Giants would go on to win that game by a score of 6-3, thanks to that three-run shot. And for Jose Cruz, it was the home run he was looking for. It was number 20 on the year.
Yeah, how about that easy swing he took?
I know. I mean, that ball jumped off his bat.
And Guillermo Moto is going to pitch. He's the one that gave it up to Cruz. And he's throwing to Eric Young, and Young takes slow. The numbers for Moto, very good. 181 ERA, 76th game. And Young takes a strike. One ball and one strike. Wilkin Ruan is now in center field. One ball and one strike. 2-1. Well, we said we'd keep an eye on GMC professional grade. Giants are scoring four or more runs, 43-12. And they've done that today. Strike to make it 2-2.
That says a lot. That says that your bullpen can hang on to a lead.
Two and two.
It just says your pitching staff's a good one.
One with a base hit.
Giants pitching staff this year went into this game in second place in the National League in pitching, a team ERA of 3.73. And in this day and age, offensively, if your staff ERA is under four, you have had a great year. Dave Rigetti should be very proud. And I think the addition of the Giants bullpen coach Mark Gardner, the tandem of Rigetti and Gardner, they were fantastic. Led by this man right here, the National League ERA champion. Congratulations to Jason Schmidt.
Here's Niku. He takes a strike. Nico had his first big league hit in the sixth inning. And he bounces this one foul.
I like watching this kid take batting practice. Yeah. You know, for him, it wasn't a grunt fest where he just get up there and try and lift and separate and knock balls in the bleachers. I mean, he really was disciplined in the type of swings that he would take. And it seemed every hit that he would have in BP would be between the gaps, out towards the middle of the diamond.
Well, a lot of times we'll be doing our scorecards and looking down and writing when the Giants are taking batting practice, and we can always tell when Bonds is hitting because you can hear it. This guy has a little bit different sound to it when he hits the ball. Out of play. Cabrera is now at third. One ball and two strikes. Young at first, nobody out. Low. 2-2. 42,142 here at the ballpark. The final totals in attendance as the Giants led the National League in attendance. 3,264,903. Nikro on the ground, slowly to third. Cabrera tosses it to Coomer. One out. We talked about Bill Miller winning the AL batting title. Pujols is 2-for-4 this afternoon. Helton's 1-for-3. Both games are still going on.
That is a great race. Never forget the first race I ever saw was my first month in the big leagues, 1976, and Bill Madlock was battling with Ken Griffey Jr. I'm sorry, Ken Griffey Sr. Ken Griffey Sr. with the Cincinnati Reds. Madlock, my teammate with the Cubs. And it went down the last day, and Ken Griffey Jr. was sitting out the game and not playing. I mean, he had this thing basically wrapped up. It would take a 4-for-4 day from Bill Madlock to win it. And after Madlock's third at bat, he was 3-for-3. And Ken Griffey Sr. was put back in the ballgame, and he struck out. And in Madlock's last at bat, he had a base hit, went 4-for-4, and won the crown.
Wow.
By the time he got to the airport to fly out that night, headlines read, front page in the Chicago Tribune, Madlock wins another one. He went to go on to win 4 batting titles. But that was pretty exciting for a rookie just getting called up. We all enjoyed it, all the guys that got called up.
Ransom did not like the call at all, and he's taken a long time. One and two. Pop up. Coomer backpedaling, makes the catch in foul territory. Two outs.
That was not easy.
Coming into today's action, the candidates for the National League MVP, Bonds, Pujols, Domi, Sheffield.
That would be a very, very interesting outcome. Certainly, 4 tremendous seasons for each one of those guys. I mean,
I think only to be fair, if you're going to put numbers up like that, you have to put intentional walks up too.
Yeah, I agree. Bonds' RBI totals down compared to the others, but he was not allowed to hit with one in position. But I think each one of those guys could give a very good argument.
Yeah, no doubt.
Our allegiance, of course, to number 25, what we saw day in, day out. In our opinion, another most valuable player year for Barry Bonds.
Feliz had a nice at bat in the sixth inning when he doubled off the wall in right field. Actually tripled off the wall, knocked in a run. limited playing time for Pedro Feliz. And he nearly comes up with 50 RBIs. He's got 46 right now, and he's got 15 home runs. 2-1. Hammers one. Hammers one. Center field. Out of here. Well, he may get the 50 yet.
Well, between Barry Bonds and Pedro Feliz in the fourth spot of the Giants' lineup today, they hit for the cycle. A single and a double for Bonds, and now a triple and a home run for Feliz. And that's his 235th at bat. And to have 16 homers and 47 RBIs and 235 at bats, that's some huge productivity.
New pitcher coming in. We're going to take a break. Pedro Feliz goes yard. We'll be back. Paul Quantrill to face Todd Linden. First pitch strike. Two outs here in the eighth inning. 89th appearance for Quantrill. And anytime one of those Dodger guys comes out of the bullpen, their ERA is always sensational.
Quantrill of 89 appearances, that leads the major leagues. So he really shouldn't be that surprised to see him into a ball game today.
One ball and one strike. And a strike, 1-2. The big cat can't wait for Tuesday. What'd he do yesterday? He had a stolen base that rocked the baseball world.
Rocked our world.
And tight strike three call. So that's from your professional announcer, Duane Kuiper. That'll do it. Ninth inning coming up.
Three Giants. We're in the top of the ninth inning. Time now for our Nissan drive of the game. For that, we go to a couple of firsts. Noah Lowry with his first big league knock off Paul Shewing, and then Lance Negro steps in and he says, I want one too, off of Paul Shuey, who gave up a couple of first big league knocks. So tonight when they put their head in the pillow, they will have big league batting averages. Welcome to the club.
Jason Christensen, the new pitcher, he'll face Cabrera. 12-3 Giants, ninth inning. Christensen deals and a swing and a fly ball to left. Torcato, another chance. And Torcato will make the catch. Numbers for Christensen. His first year back.
40th appearance. Alberto Castillo will be his catcher here in this, which should be the last inning of this ball game.
Here's Jason Romano. Romano. First time up, 3-35, and he takes the strike. One ball and one strike.
It's always a fun inning to throw, too. The last one of the regular season.
And one pitch, Romano takes a strike, 1-2. Wilken Ruan is on deck. Swing and a miss, he struck him out.
This was ball right in the hands.
Fan appreciation day. And this car was given away. It's a Toyota Prius. Now, who is the guy that was going to win it, or woman for that matter? It was this guy, and he's psyched.
That's how you're supposed to look when you win a car.
Oh, man. He's getting the hugs all the way around. Yeah, give me a high five. Here's Ruan. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-1. Three Giants going for victory number 100 on the season and a strike. Oh, and two. That's the ball game, and that's victory number 100. And Felipe Alou tipping his cat across the diamond to Jim Tracy. Tracy doing the same to his friend. And the Giants will walk off the field with a final regular season record of 100 wins and 61 losses. And fireworks above the big scoreboard. And seventh 100 win season in franchise history, and as we talked about earlier, the first since 1993 when the Giants did not go to the playoffs, but they will this year, and they will play on Tuesday against the Florida Marlins. And the Marlins with a win today as they shut out the Mets. So when it's all said and done, to say that this was a successful season would be an understatement. The Giants drew over 3 million fans again, and the fans in turn got a chance to win a team win 100 games. That's not bad.
Well, under a new skipper, with a bunch of new faces in the coaching staff, in the infield, the outfield, Felipe Alou really, really should be commended on the job that he did. And this team is strong, they're rested, and they're ready for the playoffs, and they celebrate what I think today is a team that should a milestone that should define this team, and that's the 100th win. That is something that doesn't happen very often. Only 7 times in the great Giants history has that been accomplished, and only the 3rd time in San Francisco Giants history.
Well, today we had some fun. We also saw 2 young players come up with their first major league hits, and out of Noah Lowry and Lance Niekro. So really fun at the ballpark today as the Giants come up with a laugher. All right, let's go to Glenn.
All right, thanks a lot, Duane. Well, it's been a real good year for the Giants, and maybe the happiest guy of all is Giants manager Felipe Alou. Felipe, congratulations on a tremendous year. Your first year in San Francisco, you win 100 games, you win a division. You can't ask for a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, well, I'm asking for more, you know, about winning some playoffs. Right now, the regular season is behind us, and looking forward to Tuesday. That's what we believe we're ready for it. We have good health. The guys, some of the guys got good rest, and pitching staff is healthy. So let's go on and keep winning.
What are you most proud of when you look at this regular season, a regular season that really it had everything going for the Giants?
Well, I'm proud of the way this team played baseball. I heard a lot of good things about the Giants organization, and they offered me a job, and I said, well, this is the place to go. And everything was true. And, very respectful people, very professional team, a group of guys, so I'm very proud of them, and I'm glad that I'm part of this thing.
And Felipe, the 3rd year in a row, the Giants lead the National League in attendance, 3.26 million people. How much have you enjoyed the fan support here?
Well, you know, it's incredible the way these people love their team. I played here for a long time, but it was never like this. I believe the fan support, no question about it, increased with the building of this new ballpark. Getting out of Candlestick Park, it's a great move, and putting together a great ball club.
Well, it's even going to be louder come Tuesday afternoon. Good luck in the playoffs, Felipe.
Thank you very much.
Right. Giants manager Felipe Alou, he leads the Giants to a 100-win season and the National League's Western Division title. He now turns his attention to the Florida Marlins. We'll be back to Pac Bell Park in just a moment.
Baseball is brought to you by Chevron. No gasoline cleans your engine better than Chevron with Techron. By Northern California Toyota. Check out the completely redesigned V8 4Runner at your Toyota dealer today. Get the feeling, Toyota. By Nextel, how business gets done. Call 1-800-NEXTEL-9. And by Corona and Corona Light, official sponsor of the timeout.
Well, a couple of happy fans toasting to a 100 victory season for the Giants as the Giants win today by a final of 12-3.
Time now for our Heineken Red Star player of the game, and Pedro Feliz is that man. He came in, had a couple of bats late in the ball game, hit a triple and a two-run homer. And that position in the lineup between he and Barry Bonds hit for the cycle. Bonds with a single and a double. So pretty impressive win for the Giants. I have to say that their confidence level going into the playoffs, it's right where you want it to be.
And we certainly would like to thank all of our viewers who watched very, very good baseball, and they watch this on Fox Sports Net. And Mike, another good year. So the Florida Marlins come into town on Tuesday, and it should be a fun series.
Well, I'm looking forward to it. I mean, last year's October was something that we're still tingling about, so hopefully the Giants can do real well in this October as well. So I'm looking forward to it. But I say this again, they're ready to play, they're ready to do well, and Felipe has done a good job along with his coaching staff to get these guys where they're at right now.
Yeah, we're not only just tingling about last October, we're ticked off. All right, 12-3 was the final. Coming up next, NorCal Golf Team Championships. For Glenn Kuiper, for my partner Mike Krukow, our producer Jeff Kuiper, our director Jim Lynch. We also like to thank John Ward, who was our director this year. I'm Duane Kuiper. You've been watching Giants baseball on Fox Sports Net. Thanks for joining us. Join us on the radio for all postseason games. And as always, have a good night, everybody.